Is that how we...
Ms. Birch, she is an amazing person. She's actually volunteered at the festival last year.
Yes.
I'll let you know how we first met.
Yeah, we'll get to all that. Hi, everybody.
Welcome.
Nice faces. New logistics. Normally, we're in the other...
Well, we wanted to dress up because we knew you were coming.
No, it wasn't me.
Honestly, well, the wing is under construction, so we're in a makeshift place.
Yeah. Okay.
We'll in there.
Okay. And the campus is very busy. Is it something going on there, or is just...
I think it was something.
It's something going on.
The earth science thing is in the auditorium.
Yeah, it's very busy, very busy tonight.
Appreciation.
Okay.
Step in.
All right.
Okay.
So my name is Michelle Dawes-Burt. I am founder and CEO of what I call Real Chicks Rock. It is a nonprofit organization that we've designed, really, when I say we, it's me, designed to empower, inspire, and motivate women, all women. You can look at me and see what kind of a woman I am, but it touches all women. There are other brands out there that sound similar to what I am and what I do, and so I try to make it very important that it's for all women. And there's a lot of motivational and inspirational conversations that go on, from Oprah to Joel Osteen to Jakes to whomever, and I thought that it's great to have that, but women need something more. They need to have tools, resources, and skills to be empowered. So what I've done also under the brand is I've created workshops, and I've started to work with the Atlanta Missions. I've been doing that for about 3 years now, volunteering. And my story is this. In order for people to pay attention to you or notice you, sometimes you got to show that you're worth serving and helping out. You can have something that's really great in essence, but sometimes you have to be able to be led or show that you can work well with others before people will give you an opportunity. The last time I spoke at this class, there was somebody that looked tremendously familiar to me, and I couldn't remember who that person was. And I knew that I knew them, and it was a lady who worked in the kitchen at the mission. And I had been, Ms. Pat, and I had been volunteering there, and she had no idea that I did this. And my goal was to work and basically infiltrate, right? I think when you guys talk about hot topics, that's various different ways to infiltrate markets and groups and areas of opportunity by understanding what it is that they do and trying to figure out how your brand, or in your case, how your event would fit and work with some of these topics or some of the things that you talk about. So that's what I did by going over there. I said, let me infiltrate and understand the behind the scenes and what it is that they really do. So the mission has, the thing that I like about them the most is they provide a service or a program for all women. They have 264 beds there, and they work with women to help them transition back into society. These women have had homelessness, maybe abuse, maybe drugs, but just because those things happen, we can't count them out, right? A lot of people need another opportunity for whatever the reason is. It's not our place to judge and try to figure that out, but if you have a passion to try to help somebody out and getting them back on the right road, that's what you do. So it's not for me to ask questions, it's for me to try to figure out how to help them out. So I was there serving in the kitchen, hair net, the whole thing. It's a non-speaking role. Ms. Pat runs a very tight kitchen, very clean, donations are coming in, large pantry, I'm cutting bread, I'm prepping the food because it's a lot of women and some children that need to get fed. And we did that, I tried to do that twice a week, and again, just very stealthy. And I had the opportunity of meeting the director there. And long story short, the director reached out to me because he's on my email distribution. It's another thing, we'll talk about that in a minute. Capturing people's emails. he's on my email distribution and blast, and he saw the things that I was doing, and he said to me, I want you to come and I want you to talk to our women. I want you to work with them, and I want you to present to them your program. And so we're in the process of kind of going back and forth, like the day of the week and how many people will be in the class and all of those type of things. And I'm really excited about doing that, because that takes the brand and my organization to another level, because now I have a partnership and I'm going to be in a facility helping women in a capacity, which I'm excited about doing. The Real Chicks Rock brand is something I thought of about 3 years ago. Really, God gave it to me. Without faith for me, it's impossible for me to exist. So that's my source. And I would recommend to you guys, have a source that keeps you humble, keeps you thankful, keeps you focused, keeps you grounded. My source is God, and so I tap into that every day. And he gave me this thing called Real Chicks Rock. First, it was Real Chicks Rock Chucks. Why? I am a divorced, single, I'm single now, so I'm divorced. I have a son. And at the time, I used to go to the store all the time, Target, Walmart, picking up Pampers, Huggies, wipes, the whole thing. And I noticed that women would come in there extremely dressed up, like with their kids, like kid on an ankle, one in a buggy, and they got on stilettos. And I'm like, and I noticed that men gravitated to that. Like they stop what they're doing, like, wow, look at that. She's walking by. And I'm like, because I got on sneakers, am I not as, you know, attractive? Am I not stopping traffic? And so it just kind of hit me that there is a sense of real women that don't have to look the part, right? You don't have to look like everybody else. You don't have to behave and think like everybody else. Just be you. And the focus of this started for me to be, let's try to tap in what makes us who we are and really project that. Because there's a lot of things on television